the bad guy. This may or may not be the time for a semantic debate about is he the bad guy? I don't know if he is. I definitely find myself often playing the outsider, and Richard happens to be an outsider who breaks a lot of rules and is taking care of himself the way he knows how, and consequences be damned. And it is fun. it is fun to be sneaky and be subversive and kind of mean sometimes and kind of violent sometimes, and get to indulge myself in aspects that I don't get to in daily life usually. it's an honor. I'm having a great time. Oh man, I think that it might be uncomfortable to recognize, but I think that we do have this collective fascination with the grotesque. I think that you unfortunately maybe see it in our current political landscape. You've got this figurehead that, love him or hate him, I think there's a desire to understand. Who is this man? Who is this person with such a singular moral compass? What are the needs of this person that they can go to these lengths and commit these acts for their own agenda? Richard is a brilliant mind. He's politically savvy, he's very subversive, and I think that it's thrilling for audiences to see him kind of joyously breaking all the rules and going for what he needs and going for what he wants, but then also getting to witness the consequences of his actions. The physicality really began with a conversation between director Ed Morgan and myself. Started with the text itself. What does Shakespeare say about Richard's physicality, about his body within the text that both he speaks and the other characters speak? Shakespeare wrote in a time when physical abnormality was believed to be indicative of spiritual abnormality, spiritual corruption. And Ed and I were very clear about whatever physical choices we made wanted to get us closer to the psychological gesture of Richard. How does the body inform this character's perspective and his outlook and the way he engages with the world around him? And from there, I did some research about possible causes for the types of physicality that we were wanting to work with. And from there, it's really just trying stuff out to see what my body can sustain through the process. I will say that I think Shakespeare writes his women the same way he writes his men. That Shakespeare's characters are three-dimensional. The language lends itself to a range of choices, of interpretations, and these are people in complex situations that have complex morality. And I think that it speaks just as much, if not more, to contemporary society and a contemporary sensibility and socio-political conversation that we're having today, that informs, that's almost more about what comes through in this language. And so to have this opportunity to go toe-to-toe with these women, these four very distinct women who are powerful and strong and speak their truth in amazing opposition, it's thrilling. And makes me so excited that those are the kinds of things we're grappling with and the things that are at the fore, and that it's reflected not just in today's conversations, but in these conversations that were happening 400 plus years ago. And that's what makes Shakespeare universal.